Good morning and welcome to the June 7th Sangha Service. My name is Max Lan.
I'm Kyan Ichinose, and we are part of BCSF Junior YBA, and we are chairing today's service.
During today's service, we'll be starting with the kansho. Then we will have a meditative reading of the three treasures. After that, we will have chanting of Gassho With Amida. Our Dharma talk will be given by Leo Jocelyn Sensei. Following this, we'll be reading the Golden Puzzle. Finally, we'll end with appreciations and announcements.
We will now begin the meditative reading of the three treasures, which can be found on page 8 of the Purple Service Book. If you do not have a copy, the link to download it can be found below this video. It should also be projected on the screen so you can follow along.
Hard is it to be born into human life. Now we are living it. Difficult is it to hear the teachings of the Blessed One. Now we hear it. If we do not realize the truth in this life, when will it be realized? Let us reverently take refuge in the three treasures of the truth. I take refuge in the Buddha. May we absorb ourselves in the principle of the way to enlightenment and awaken in ourselves the supreme will. I take refuge in the Dharma. May we be submerged in the depths of the doctrine and gain wisdom as deep as the ocean. I take refuge in the Sangha. May we live in harmony in the great assembly as disciples of Buddha and be freed from all hindrances, becoming units of true accord in the life of harmony, in a spirit of universal oneness, freed from the bondage of selfishness. Even through myriad ages of kalpas, hard is it to hear such an excellent, profound, and wonderful doctrine. Now we are able to hear and receive it. Let us thoroughly understand the true meaning of Tathagata's teaching. Namo Amidabutsu. Namo Amidabutsu. Namo Amidabutsu.
Next, we will have a chanting of Gassho with Amida, which will be led by Reverend Kobata.
In the clear bright I live in great compassion. This great power guides my life. I Gassho with Amida.
Now we'll have a Dharma talk from Leo Jocelyn Sensei.
Hello, my name is Leo Jocelyn, and I'm a minister's assistant at the Buddhist Church of San Francisco. Welcome to our Sunday morning service for June 7, 2020. Please join me in Gassho as I read the words of Shinran Shonin from the Taneshiyo. In this fleeting world, this burning house, all matters without exception are empty and false, totally without truth and sincerity. Then Mbutsu alone is true and real. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. So this passage from Shinran describes the world as fleeting, impermanent, like a burning house. And the world really does seem to be burning right now. There's so much happening. And the past few days have been very difficult. Things are happening very quickly, and so it's possible that by the time you hear this talk, that it will be obsolete, because we're recording it at the end of the week on Friday for our service on Sunday morning, and we don't know what's going to happen Friday, Saturday night. I hope that the talk remains relevant and that you might find it helpful. But the world is burning. Over the past few days, we've seen some very difficult things. We're horrified to witness the death of George Floyd. And we're seeing how the anger and the despair can't help but arise after centuries of oppression and racial injustice. And this is already on top of a pandemic. It's on top of economic devastation, with millions of people losing their jobs. There are very difficult things happening, and these are very difficult days. And so what's a Buddhist to do? And so that's something I've been dealing with over the past few days. What is a Buddhist response for what's happening in our world today? And that's quite a daunting question, and I can't answer it. There are so many different types of Buddhists. There are so many ways to approach Buddhism. All I can do is share what this Buddhist sees as an approach from my own opinions. And if anything is helpful here, that would be my hope. But I'd like to start by reading something written by Thich Nhat Hanh from his book, Being Peace. And to put this into perspective, back in between the years 1975 and 1992, somewhere around there, it's estimated that between 1 and 1.2 million people fled Vietnam, doing so in boats, called boat people. And the United Nations estimates that between 200 and 400,000 of them did not survive. They died on the stormy seas, they drowned, many of them died from disease, starvation, many from pirate attacks. And so I just wanted to remind us of the scale of this. But Thich Nhat Hanh has written about this experience, and I wanted to read what he wrote. In Vietnam, there are many people called boat people who leave the country in small boats. Often the boats are caught in rough seas or storms. The people may panic and boats can sink. But if even one person aboard can remain calm, lucid, knowing what to do and what not to do, he or she can help the boat survive. His or her expression, face, voice communicates clarity and calmness, and people have trust in that person. They will listen to what he or she says. One such person can save the lives of many. So right now, our world is like a small boat. We're in this boat on these very stormy seas. And so I really love what he wrote, because I do believe that one calm person can help everyone stay grounded. And so for a while, I've been saying that, yeah, this is a Buddhist approach. This is going to be my Buddhist approach to what's happening in the world today, to struggle to be the calm one, and to see if I can help others in that manner. But given everything that's been happening, it's really clear that that alone needs to be expanded. And so I would suggest that besides being the calm person in the boat, that we also turn toward the others in the boat and move toward the suffering. And so that's how I'm seeing my own Buddhist approach, being the calm person. So I'm going to start there and then move on to turning towards suffering. So how are we to be the calm person in the boat? For many of us, as Shin Buddhists, saying the Nembutsu is the way we can be that calm person, because we have that inner foundation, knowing that we are grasped, never to be let go, knowing that the primal vow is always at work. And that often works for me, to say the Nembutsu, and then I feel a sense of calm, of clarity, and I can be that calm person. But Shinran Shonin describes us as Bonbu, as foolish, ordinary beings, and that's all I am. And so I find that there are times when my emotions will get in the way. As stated by Shinran in the Shoshinge, the light of compassion that grasps us illumines and protects us always. The darkness of our ignorance is already broken through. Still, the clouds and mists of greed and desire, anger and hatred cover as always the sky of true and real Shinjin. And so that's what happens with me. The clouds get in the way. So what can I do? And I find that what's helpful for me personally is mindfulness meditation. Now, mindfulness is simply a way of being. It's a way of paying attention. It's paying attention to the present moment without judgment. is not a way to seek enlightenment for me. We're not trying to become enlightened. We're not sitting in order to accumulate merit. We're simply getting to know ourselves better. We're calming the mind, settling the mind. And in doing so, we find that we can react skillfully or respond skillfully to what's happening around us rather than reacting emotionally. And so for me, those are the ways that I can be that calm person on the boat. But that in itself may be very helpful, but at the same time, it feels that I need to look around the boat, see who's there. We need to see who's in the boat with us. So when we look around this metaphorical boat, we must recognize that the suffering of Black people has become unbearable and intolerable because racism and racist injustice has been pervasive throughout history. So when we are not fused with our emotions, when the skies have cleared of the clouds, I believe we're better able to live the Nembutsu, and in doing so, we can't help but move toward suffering. As Shinran wrote in the Tanishio, if we revere the power of the vow all the more deeply, gentleness and forbearance will surely arise in us through its spontaneous working. With everything we do, we should constantly and fervently call to mind Amida's immense benevolence without any thought of being wise. Then the Nembutsu will indeed emerge. So as the Nembutsu emerges, and as I move toward others, I remember our interconnections. Again from Shinran, hymns based on gathas in praise of Amida Buddha. The light of wisdom exceeds all measure, and every finite being receives this illumination that is like the dawn. So we recognize that the light of Amida shines on everyone. We are all equal and interconnected. So Martin Luther King Jr. recognized this. In his famous letter from Birmingham jail, he writes, "We are caught in an inescapable network of mutuality, tied in a single garment of destiny. Whatever affects one directly affects all directly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be. And you can never be what you ought to be until I am what I ought to be. This is the interrelated structure of reality." So Martin Luther King Jr. really sounds very Buddhist in that statement. And as a reminder, Martin Luther King Jr. nominated Thich Nhat Hanh for the Nobel Prize back in the 60s for his work during the Vietnam War. In the collected works of Shinran, Shinran quotes a sutra. This is just a segment, a tiny segment. "How great it is, the true Dharma, the ultimate reality, is oneness." So, as we remember our interconnections, and as we turn toward others who are suffering, I hope to be able to do that from a place of loving kindness, from metta and compassion. In Martin Luther King Jr.'s speech or sermon, "Loving Your Enemies," he says, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that." And he seems to be drawing from the words of Shakyamuni Buddha 2,600 years ago, who said, "For never does hatred cease by hatred at any time. Hatred ceases by love. This is an eternal law." So with rigorous honesty, can I ask myself some important questions? With this in mind, responding skillfully rather than emotionally, it helps me ask some important questions. How are others suffering? Have I contributed in some way to that suffering? Can I listen to them and really hear them? What can I do to alleviate their suffering? What can I do to prevent suffering? And in light of recent events, there are hard questions to ask. Do I harbor any racism within myself? Am I forgetting the ways that I am privileged? Am I forgetting that so many others are far less advantaged than I am? Now, asking these questions is an action. It's a form of taking action. And as we move towards suffering, we cannot help but take action. I believe that that's so if the Nembutsu is emerging from within us. Some of the actions that we can take, these actions can take various forms. It's one, learning more about the history of Black people and how it's been impacted by racism. Peaceful protest, nonviolent demonstration, political engagement, educational efforts, putting pressure on institutions that discriminate on the basis of race, examining our entire system to see how racism has become manifest systematically and supported by the system. These are all actions that we can take. But first I have to start with myself. I have to start with exploring my heart. That, I believe, is a Buddhist approach. I'd like to close with something that does not come from the Buddha or Shinran, maybe indirectly, but this comes from an elder of the Hopi tribe, the Hopi people. It's called A Hopi Elder Speaks. There is a river flowing now very fast. It is so great and swift that there are those who will be afraid. They will try to hold on to the shore. They will feel they are torn apart and will suffer greatly. Know the river has its destination. The elders say we must let go of the shore, push off into the middle of the river, keep our eyes open and our heads above water. And I say, see who is in there with you and celebrate. At this time in history, we are to take nothing personally, least of all ourselves. For the moment that we do, our spiritual growth and journey comes to a halt. The time for the lone wolf is over. Gather yourselves. Banish the word struggle from your attitude and our vocabulary. All that we do now must be done in a sacred manner and in celebration. We are the ones we've been waiting for. So in that last line, this elder, this Hopi elder, speaks to my heart as a Shin Buddhist. We are the ones that we've been waiting for. But the thing is that we've always been here. I've only let the clouds get in the way. So I believe that ultimately healing will happen, that this is an opportunity for us to heal. So as for my Buddhist approach, keeping a clear mind, recognizing our interconnections, turning towards suffering with compassion, metta, and loving kindness. I hope that all of us explore and determine our own Buddhist response to our world today, our fleeting world. Please join me in Gassho. How great it is, the true Dharma, the ultimate reality, is oneness. Namo Amida Buddha. Namo Amida Buddha. Thank you for joining us today. And my aspirational prayer is that we will all be able to meet soon again in person in our temple to celebrate the infinite light and immeasurable life of Amida Buddha. Thank you.
Thank you, Sensei. Now we'll have a meditative reading of The Golden Puzzle by Kyan.
I am a piece in Buddha's golden puzzle of love and life that connects the world. I must keep my peace bright and strong. I will try to be kind and honest with all beings, including myself. I will try to think clear and helpful thoughts, to speak clear and helpful words, and to do kind and helpful deeds, knowing that what I do now depends not only on my happiness or unhappiness, but also that of others. May every piece in Buddha's golden puzzle of love and life become bright and strong, and may we all realize and become perfect peace.
We would like to thank Reverend Kobata, Leo Jocelyn Sensei, and Kevin Yoza for helping us share this service.
Are there any announcements?
On Tuesday at 2 p.m., there is a book club reading of Why Buddhism is True. On Wednesday at 6:30 p.m., there is a mindfulness meditation and discussion. Please call BCSF or email instructions on how to join. June 9th is Bento Day. Please contact Arlene Kimata for details. Since we will not be having our traditional Ginza Bazaar and our Bon Festival this year, we'd like to close today's service with a musical remembrance from last year's Bon Odori featuring Tokyo Sukaitsuri.
Thank you for joining us for today's virtual Sangha service. Take care, stay safe, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Namu Amida Butsu, Namu Amida Butsu, Namu Amida.
Hey, hey, don't run out of time.